Okay, as you can see, Chris, we're
Astro One, go
cruising
ahead.
Here.
We're at your own risk. Wind 2501.
At about a fuel burn of 10 gallons an hour, which is normal at speed. You can go down
Astro
if you pull the nose up a little and
right. If you
throttle back.
Please do.
And that's what I'm doing right now. And I'm using the heading bug to make my turn. We're making a 90 degree turn. Fuel burn is down to about 7.5, which is a little low. I'll pull the nose up a little bit more. We're cruising at 1900 AGL, or MSL, I'm sorry.
So Ralph, how long have you owned the airplane for?
I bought the airplane in 1977. From two guys, one of whom bought a house, the other one got married, couldn't afford to keep it anymore, and I've had it ever since, and it's been hangered ever since too. The airplane now has 4,400 hours approximately on the airframe, and 1920 on the remanufactured engine, which I bought in 82-83. It's all in the logs. I got a new logbook back then, and I've been flying it ever since. It's been very well maintained. All the annuals, and even between the annuals, I always made sure everything was in the best of shape. So the airplane is, as far as I'm concerned, meets all expectations. The annual was just done in May, and it's an ideal airplane. It has the S-Tech 30 in here, which allows me to fly hands-off most of the time. And now I'm using the heading bug, but I can put it on the GPS. Even though this is a portable GPS, it is hooked into the S-Tech 30 autopilot and is legal, although it can be disconnected because it should not be, shall we say, submitted to the FAA as it is, but it is switchable off and on. It can be switched to the VOR, ILS approach, or almost anything you want, and therefore is fully functional, just like a regular Garmin GPS built into the panel, which typically has a smaller screen than the portable. I actually like the portable a lot better than what they give you on the on the regular built-in panel-mounted
right.
GPS.
And that's a Garmin 296?
That's a Garmin 296, yep.
0066, close to tower.
The panel, as you can see, is fully IFR, although I have to admit the DME and ADF are fairly old units, King, but I rarely, if ever, use them anymore because I have the GPS. GPS is fully functional both on autopilot and regular flying, obviously. You can set this on the heading bug, the autopilot. You can set it on the ILS approach or VOR radio and the navigation radios, and you can have it flying off the GPS. So it is fully functional, and I've used it quite a bit, and have made some pretty low approaches, virtually almost down to 600-700 feet, all pretty much without having to rely on anything other than the autopilot. Again, we're holding at about 2,000 feet and burning about 7.2 and 8.5 gallons an hour.
Is that pretty typical for this airplane?
It is when you fly slow. As you can tell, I'm flying at only about 2,100 RPM. The minute as you saw when we took off, we actually were climbing at 1,500 feet there for a minute, and it is capable of doing an outstanding job in climbing. You'd be surprised. You cannot stall this airplane if you're on the full power.
Right.
I mean, I can just pull pull the nose up and it'll just hang on the prop.
Well, I started out down a dirty road. Started out all alone. And the sun went down as I crossed the hill. And the town lit up, the world got still. I'm learning to fly, but I ain't got wings. Coming down is the hardest thing. Well, the good old days may not return, and the rocks might melt, and the seed may burn. I'm learning.